Hi everyone, welcome to Module 2. This is a brief training on inserting images and playing with text a little bit. So the first thing to do with your announcement section is to turn the editing on. In this case, I have the editing on already. You're going to be editing this beginning box. This is our course, so we have a lot here. You won't have this here, you'll just have News Forum. Go ahead and click the little icon to edit. And you come to the box welcome or announcements. Simply pop a return or two in, and we're going to add some text, and we will also add a photo. So one of the simpler ways I find is just to go ahead and add text. In this case, I believe I have some right here. I'm just going to add in case someone's live in the course. And you'll see there's a difference. This is 4 point or number four text, 14 point. It's also bold. This text is actually 8 point. I'm going to change this a little bit, but this will be 10 point. And I will just take a quick look and see how it comes out. And it looks a little off. I'm going to play with that a second. And that is now 12 point, and it looks more normal for the course. So this is perfect. That's my text. There's my header. I'd like to add a photo, and I'm going to add this photo right at the beginning. I will use the image icon right here. Now, let's assume you've already found a photo, and we'll come up with some locations to find them. But you need to get the photo from your computer to Moodle. So use Browse. And let's see if I have a photo here somewhere. Look a little better. Here we go. Here's a photo of me. And that will be just fine. So we will click Open. And I'll see that photo pop up right down here and simply click upload. This now puts the photo in Moodle. So here's my photo. So that I can insert the photo, and I'm actually not going to use that one. I'll use fireworks because it is the 4th of July. But to use the photo, just click the image, and you'll see up here the width and height of the photo. This is really quite large. I am going to do some very quick mental math, and I'm going to cut that right in half. And 640 looks right. And this box also asks for alternate text. That's for readers, for people who are using a optical reader, which is telling them what the photo is of if they are vision impaired. That was fireworks. And I'm going to make the alignment be left, so this will be in the left side of the page. And so that my photo does not bump into the text, I will add spacing, and I will add six, roughly six picas, I believe. And say okay. And you can see now my photo is rather large and my text is rather crunched. I can now adjust things a little better manually. And you'll see as I go up or down, I'm changing the shape of my photo. I'm also discovering that this text is very close to that photo. So I'm going to change that by simply the photo selected, go back to the image. And that is vertical, so I'm going to change this to 10 instead of 6. And let me just move this over. You'll see my size has been adjusted, and I'll say OK. And I now have a reasonably clean line here. I try to keep things pretty lined up, and I avoid huge white space. And it's also very important to cite where the photo is from. So this was image source. This is one of my favorite sites. And I will make that be in smaller font. And whoops, I don't want to do it to everything. So hopefully I can just do that right there. We'll make that 8 point and save changes. You'll see that I've created an issue here, and the reason I believe is that my spacing now is too great. So I need to go back, edit. I will rechange the spacing, and let's just this time do 7. Again, I'll say OK, and I'm going to hope this looks a little better, and save changes. It still doesn't. Whoops. So, I'm going to play with this until I get it right. I see my text is up too high, my photo's now a better size, and I'm saving. And there you go. So it took me 3 tries. It's not ideal, but it's pretty good, and I'm reasonably happy with this. So you get a sense of what it looks like when it doesn't go perfect the first time. I'll turn editing off. And it looks reasonably clean. Actually, I'm not too sad about the way that looks. Now, the other option would have been, let me re-edit this. My other option would have been to not put my text in this way, but instead to have made a box, a table. And I use one row, one column. In this case, it's a very small, very narrow box. I do not use borders around boxes. I'll say OK. There's my box right here. Paste, Apple V. I would like to put this in the box as well. So I'm going to add that. Again, paste that in. Now things are a little cleaner. I can widen this box a little bit to broaden my text. Things look okay. We'll try this. And you've just discovered that my box was too wide. So, again, I'll play with that. And really, this is all about playing until things look right. And sometimes these little things take a bit of time. So, this is becoming fraught with issues. And I will raise my box up. I'll keep it narrow. I'll even draw this up higher. And finally, it looks pretty decent. So there we go. I have another issue here with extended space underneath. So I will go down here, draw that box up, get rid of some of these extra spaces. And you'll see I had like 4 extra spaces. Save changes again. And there you go. Now it's not bad, and it looks pretty decent. So that's the trick. When you are editing this front section and you play with things, there's 2 different ways, using tables and using just regular text. Play around with that, see what you can find that works well for you. All right? Thanks. Again, drop any questions in the box, in the Have a Question or the Technical Question box, and we'll get some answers going. Thanks.